Okay, in the last section, we worked on modeling the fuselage and got it down to like a pretty low poly version. And something I mentioned was previously we had, I had always had students create the wings as part of the model, so it was one uniform thing. And that I just thought, like, well, wouldn't it be great if we could make it so you could potentially articulate the wings? It will also make the modeling a lot easier if these are in different parts, and it's something that could be potentially more useful than just like a static model that's all one polygon object. So we are going to go ahead and get started on the wings and the rest of it. And we're, again, right, we're trying to make this like this one like low poly version that's going to work for us. And so we're going to go back to model mode, right? So we're going to click on model mode because we're going to be using some primitives to start with. And what I want to do is I want to be able to, right, you can see the wings are really pretty thin. I'm surprised they stay on during space flight, but you know, that's how an X-wing works, right? So we're gonna, if we look at all the different views a little bit, this one's not so useful, although it does show it taper some. Right, we can see the general shape of the wing, flat front, you know, but then there's just this corner edge. So what we're gonna do is we are going to create a cube. And I want to get this, it set to be, you know, somewhat close to the size of this wing. So I'm going to go ahead and pull this really thin. And then I am going to go ahead and see here. I am going to do some adjustments and things to make this thing fit. So let's go ahead and we're actually going to move this off axis or off the origin. We're going to go in our side view because this is just going to be the easiest to start with. I'm going to bring this up here. I want you to note that I'm not going to be rotating anything yet, and I'm just starting to try and get the scale somewhat close, and you'll see, right, I'm doing all of this is acting around the center, and that's why I'm not doing any rotation yet, because we will be able to have a much better effect if we change this up. So I've got this thing stretched out so it's more or less the right length. It's a little bit too thick, but I want it to kind of end, you know, right about there. And I've got one of them. And we're going to do a couple steps to mirror this here in a second. So let's go ahead and switch views because I know this is going to be too far forward. If I go to my top view, which is going to be the most useful view next, you can see it's a little bit too far forward. So I'm going to pull this down, and again, it's going to shrink around the center. So I'm intentionally leaving it out. The engines we're going to model separately. And at least to start with, so we don't need to worry about that. But basically, you want to get the width. Oops, sorry, I'm trying to actually select the axis here. Here we go. We want to be able to fit that point there and the front edge in here. You can see it looks really long in this view, and that's right because it's still laying flat. It's not up at an angle, which is going to give us some shortening in this view when we get to that point. Okay, so we've got this set. And at this point, in order to do the angle and everything, I am going to want to make this object editable, because then I can use this axis, enable axis tool, put the axis here, rotate it, and then do some point manipulation to, right, taper the wing and all of that. So let's go ahead and we will hit the letter C on the keyboard to make it editable, or right click on the button with the hexagon and the pen or pencil or whatever. And so I've made this editable. Now I'm going to click on enable axis or use the letter L, and I'm going to drag this axis all the way over here. And now that I've got my axis moved, but the object should still be where it's supposed to be, I can use my rotate tool, hover over the blue edge, the one that's like facing the camera, and start rotating. Oops. But you'll notice I start rotating and nothing happens. That's because I still have enable axis on. Got to turn that off. Always forget. And now I can rotate this, and I can actually rotate this so it aligns with the wing. And I happen to get that thickness almost exactly right just by default, which is, you know, kind of awesome. Not to toot my own horn. That just happens to be luck, I think. All right. So now the only other issue is, right, you can see this is still seems a little bit long in this view, but it seems accurate in this view. And it's maybe a little bit beyond the end of the wing here, so maybe I should take care of that first. So I'm going to go to points mode, and I am going to use my live selection tool. I'm going to make sure visible only is unchecked. I'm going to select all of these points because I want this to move as uniform, and I'm just going to come in here somewhere. So it is a little shorter, right? It still looks a little long in this view, and the, you know, so the question kind of becomes whether or not you want to, you know, this is where like, which one do we trust? And I'm going to go with the basics. I'm going to say this is, as long as it, you know, somewhat aligns with the width here at the end, I'm happy. And you'll see, I probably want one more set of polygons here so I can, because there's this inset cut thing that happens in the wing. That I'm going to want to accommodate as well. And I'm going to go ahead and do that now. So I'm going to use the loop cut tool, which is the letter K and then L, or it's over here. And if this isn't visible, it's under the knife, right? Because the knife icon is the one that's usually there. And so I'm going to say, okay, well, here's where that corner is more or less. So I'm going to click, I'm going to hit escape to set that cut. And yeah, it looks like that should probably do it for me, although I might need one more, but we're going to start here and see where we get to. So I'm going to hit the space bar so I can do live selection, select these points, pull this down here. All right, I've got these points here where the wing actually connects up here somewhere. And then the other thing I need to do, right, is I actually need one more cut in order to do this. So we're gonna say K and L. I'm gonna do a cut right there, hit escape, space bar, select these points, move these up here. Then I want to go to my perspective view and I wanna make sure that I haven't mangled my model in any way, shape, or form. It looks like that is pretty accurate. Okay, so I've got my one wing. Now, I don't want to make this wing again, right? And so I'd like to do symmetry, but for whatever reason, it's like it's not working, right? The symmetry is happening over here. Now, if I go back to model view, the reason the symmetry is happening there is because that's where my axis for my entire object is centered at this point. Right, because I used enable axis. If I had, if I was to click on this and drag it over here, and then go back to polygon mode, you'll see my plane of symmetry has also changed. So that's something else that can be dangerous because I could be selecting a point and manipulating everything. So just be cautious of that if you have symmetry enabled. I'm going to undo that. And now I want to copy this wing over here, and I'd like to be able to manipulate these with symmetry as though they are one object. And so what I need to do in order to make this symmetrical across this axis is if I go into my generators, one of the generator options down here is also called symmetry. And what this does is this will allow me to take an object, make it a child, and it will automatically copy that object to the other side of the wherever this central axis is. So if I select my symmetry object and look at the attributes, you'll see that by default it's set to planar, not radial. If I did radial, we'd have a lot of wings in all different directions. So it's planar, and it's in the x plus to minus. If I did minus to plus, I don't think we're going to have any difference there at this point. But if I was doing this in the z direction as well, right, it's going to add two more wings across that axis, which I don't want to do, so I'm turning that off. I can also have it add wings along the y-axis. And the only thing to check here is, are those two bottom wings going to be exactly where I want them to be aligned with my model? So I'm going to go ahead and check in my front view real quick. I'm going to zoom out and look at that. They are exactly where I want them to be, which is pretty fantastic. It means that I aligned this drawing really well. And that's great. Now we've got wings. Now, one thing, my wings are kind of terminating in space right now, and there's a gap. This is something we can fix a little bit later once we finish modeling the body of this object a bit more. Okay, so we also want to maybe take this time to throw some engines on here and throw the general like shape of these of the blasters or whatever they are on there as well. So let's go ahead and take some time to do that. So we're going to create some cylinders. All right, so I've got my cylinder. I want this to be Z plus as the orientation. So I'm going to go ahead and go with my cylinder selected, go to Z plus here. Now it's in the right orientation. I am going to align this one to the same wing that I started with. If I ever forget what wing I started with, I just turn symmetry off, and that makes it a little bit easier to see. And now I can start to align this with that. Now, obviously, it's absolutely massive. And it's going to need to be a little bit smaller than this when we go forward, but that gets it to somewhat the right position. Now I can go into my other views and I can say, okay, this is about where the engines start. Let's check this front view. Maybe I move this forward a touch. Let's go ahead and make this a lot smaller in diameter or radius. I'm going to scoot this over. That seems pretty good there. Now you'll note this thing thins out a lot as it goes down. We're not worried about that right now. All we're going to focus on is getting the length and everything right and the position right. So I'm going to go ahead and maybe center this a bit better. So when I stretch this out, it stretches a bit more uniformly. I might move this out just a touch more. Again, we can always change, do little tweaks later. And then I'm going to go ahead and grab this and bring this up here. You'll see there is some extra material on there, but I'm just going to leave this set just like it is right now to block out that basic thing. Now, I'd like to add this cylinder to my symmetry, right? Because I want this to be symmetrical as well. So if I come down here and plop that in there, now I've got my four engines in my symmetry. This is pretty fantastic, right? That means that everything's aligned the way we want them to be. Now, for modeling, this works really well. Once we go and we want these wings, if we wanted to have these wings articulate, we would probably, right, we'll do some editing to make these wings actual objects instead of just copies of one another. But that's for a little bit later in this process. Okay, so we've got the engines. Let's go ahead and put our blasters. And again, we're just going to do a really long cylinder to start with, of one size. And so we're going to go create another cylinder. We know that Z plus is the right orientation. Obviously, a radius of 50 is a little bit much. So we're going to make this 10 right now because I know that's about right, probably. And now it's probably going to be easier for me to align this based on the front view. And I just need to make sure I know, again, what which wing is the one that I've been working on, and you'll notice it's this one over here. It's hard to see, but I could select it and get that visible, but it's over here in this view, and I'm going to go ahead and line that up more or less. I am going to make this a lot longer in the side view. It could be even a little bit longer. That should work. You know, and again, right, this is where, right, things aren't perfectly aligned in all of the views. And so I can get close with this. You can see it really depends. I either choose one or I just have like things slightly off. But in the end, the important thing is like, is it actually attached where it should be on the wing, right? And if I look at my side view, there's like a little bit of a chunk of something that connects it, and this is still a little bit small. So I'm going to go ahead and scale up my axis a touch, which should make it come in contact or close to contact with that. I could add another object in there as well, or you know, eventually I could add a little bit more geometry to the wing and then just have it kind of taper up so it connects to the blaster. But I'm going to hold off on that because, right, there's a lot of different shapes that happen on this thing as we go. And now similarly, right, if I turn my symmetry back on and make this cylinder a child, now I have all four of those. Symmetry is a magical thing when you're working with symmetrical objects. So because these are just called cylinders, I'm going to change the names of these so that I know what they are. So this is going to be the blaster, we'll call it. I can't remember. That's probably like a cannon of some sort, but whatever, it doesn't matter. And this one is the engine. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and save this. And now we have really the basics of our X-Wing blocked out, right? It doesn't look super accurate yet. Those engines might be pushing through that surface just a touch more than I would like them to. But we're in a really good place to continue to work. So the next thing I think that we need to do is we probably need to go back to the fuselage and start adding a little bit more detail. Again, we're going to try and keep this as minimal as possible in order to do this. But you can see, right, part of the reason there's a gap here is because if I look at my front view, right, there's a little bit, we're still missing an edge here to pull out some of this shape. And there's, you know, a lot more work to do with what the cockpit looks like and everything else. Okay.